In this step, we're going to equalize the stub impedances, and we're going to do that because those stubs are going to be realized essentially by the individual microstrip lines making up our parallel coupled line filter. From step 5, we had this design. So we had two 50 ohm inverters separating three hybrid resonators. The characteristic impedance Z01 is 7.54 ohms, and that's equal to Z03. But Z02 has a different characteristic impedance. It is 5.82. Now this is a broadband design, and that's good, but we want the stubs to have the same characteristic impedance. And the result of this step, after we do the transformations that we're going to talk about now, is we're going to end up with this design. Z01, Z03, and Z02 have the same characteristic impedance. So let's consider where we are in our synthesis. So at the top here is our current prototype, and this is our target physical realization. Now these inverters are going to be realized using stubs. We haven't got to that point yet, but the two stubs in parallel, we will see, can be equated to a single stub, and that stub is realized essentially by a single microstrip line. We can ignore the coupling for the moment, and that first effective stub, which combines Z01 with the value coming from the inverter, is going to be realized by that first line. Z03 will be realized by the final line, and Z02, along with the stub impedances coming from the inverter, are going to be realized by that central line. However, for the moment, we're just going to consider Z01, Z02, and Z03 on their own. It's not as accurate as we would possibly like, but for the stage we're at the moment, that's what we need to do. Again, we're going to realize those stubs by those individual microstrip lines. So the impedances of the shunt stubs are mostly determined by the impedances of the individual microstrip lines. And those characteristic impedances are determined by the width of the line, and for manufacturability reasons, we would like the microstrip lines to have the same width. Therefore, we want the shunt stubs to have the same characteristic impedance. So we're doing a physical consideration at the moment and going back to what we need to do in the synthesis. Now there will be some series stubs, and they will come when we realize the inverter. But those series stubs essentially come from the coupling of one microstrip line to the next. So here's the procedure we're going to follow. We want Z02 scale so that Z02 is equal to Z01. We are going to do this by looking at that inverter-resonator-inverter combination. We're going to replace the resonator by an admittance for the moment, and so we're just going to consider the inner part, the part that's within the dashed box line, and we're going to use this equivalent circuit to figure out what is going on. Now often when we do equivalences, we use ABCD parameters, but for here, it's really the admittance that makes the analysis a lot easier. And we're going to use the admittances because we're going to equate two circuits by building the nodal admittance matrix of each of those circuits. Here is our original network, our A network. We're going to take those inverters and realize them using lumped elements. So those admittance inverters, J's, are going to be realized by three lumped elements each. So that's the first admittance inverter. And these values are impedances, and Y is just our central admittance. And we want to equate that circuit to this circuit down here, with a different value of Y1. In fact, we want to scale Y to realize a new admittance. Of course, what we're going to be doing here is we're going to scale the characteristic impedance of that stub. So the admittances are the same if D is equal to J times the square root of X. More specifically, the nodal admittance matrices of those two circuits, and they will be two-port matrices, will be the same if D is equal to JX. Now that we've done the scaling, we will look at these three lumped elements and we will take it back to the form of an admittance inverter. and the admittance inverter will be scaled by a factor, the square root of x. As an example, let's say we're going to try and realize a 1 nanohenry series inductor. Well, we know that we can realize that by a shunt capacitor with two unity admittance inverters. We can scale this so that our admittance inverters are 0.1 siemens, and we will also scale the capacitor C. So if we had 10 ohm impedance inverters, so we're just taking a 0.1 siemen admittance inverters and turning them into 10 ohm impedance inverters, it's exactly the same element, it depends whether we use siemens or ohms. We see that our capacitor is really 10 picofarads. So we have done a tremendous scaling. We have gone from 1 nanofarad to 10 picofarad. We can scale the admittance values by a tremendous amount if we want to. In summary, this is our step 6. We are simply scaling things so that Z01 is equal to Z02. So we're taking our central admittance element here, which is a hybrid resonator. We're scaling it appropriately so that the characteristic impedances of the three stubs are the same.